After the One Love Peace concert, Jim Brown showed up to Bob's place on Hope Road to deliver some of the money from the ticket sales.
Jim Brown was the most powerful don in the ghetto. His garrison was Tivoli, but he was henchman for the whole JLP.
One of my most important informants, Trevor Phillips, was with Bob when Jim Brown showed up. Marley took Trevor aside and said, "Who is this man? What is he doing up here?" And Trevor said to Bob, "But don't you know Jim Brown?" And Bob said, "Trevor, I saw that man up here the night I was shot."
Bob told me when he saw him later on, that was the guy who was there the night of the shooting. I don't know if Jim actually fired the gun, but that was the guy who was there the night of the shooting.
You never saw the gunman?
At that time, no.
But you know who did it?
Yeah.
Were they caught?
No, but I don't call the police. Oh. Just, you know, quarantine.
I recognize the gunman, man, who come. He was a laborer, man. He was not a man.
I think that it was Jim Brown who masterminded that shooting, because it would have been a way to secure his bona fides with Siaga. It also launched Jim Brown.
Jim Brown went on to form the notorious Shower Posse. The Shower Posse became one of the prime smugglers of cocaine, heroin into North America.
It took the authorities a long time to realize how murderous this man was, because he was under the protection of Edward Siaga from the beginning.